Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Creator's Spotlight. Today we have a forger who a lot of you have probably been seeing around on the Leech co-op build. His name is UneeQ Forges. Introduce yourself, man.
Hey everybody, my name is UneeQ, or most of my friends know me as Ryan. But yeah, hello.
Well, it's great to meet you, and we also have another Ryan here on the chat here with us, a Forge Hub member, Foge. He will chime in every now and again with a question or two, but let's hop right into this. So when it comes to when you started your forging career and stuff, when did you start, or what would you consider your start?
Probably when Foundry came out for the first map pack on Halo 3. Was that the Legendary map pack?
The Legendary Heroic. I believe it was the Heroic, but if I'm wrong on that, then I'm sure someone in the comments will correct me.
Yeah, one of those two.
What'd you start building when you were on there?
Man, that's a good question.
Was your first map like a mini game? Was it a 4v4 style map? Like, what'd you tend to build on?
Yeah, most of my maps on Halo 3 were based around arena style MLG maps, because I was very keen on recreating maps that were in the style of Onslaught and Amplified.
Okay.
So my maps are more focused around symmetrical 4v4 competitive. Nice. At that time, anyway.
Nice. That's really sick. I know a lot of people back then had some pretty good 4v4 maps, both on Foundry and Sandbox. So that'd be pretty unique to see. Are you planning to bring over any of those like old maps that you worked on for like Infinite in the future or anything like that, like when the Forge fully comes out? Or
since a lot of our stuff on our file share was actually saved, I have quite a few maps from and Halo 4 that I can easily bring up in Forge still and go back and check out some of those maps, because there's quite a few that I have probably forgotten about that are still pretty good to play on.
That's sick, man. Did you forge long in Halo 4? Because I know a lot of people back then kind of gave Halo 4 a shot and then kind of stopped. And then like there's some other people like me and some other people that I've seen that have continued on and still forged in that. Did you keep forging at that point and like through, or when did your Halo 4 career, I guess, start and or end? If that makes sense.
I think Halo 4 was probably the peak of my quality when it came to map building.
Okay.
Even though a lot of people think Halo 4 was like a little bit of a downgrade from Reach, just due to like piece-wise, but I've seen it as a bit of an upgrade just by environment-wise.
Yeah.
There was a little bit more to forge with and a different look.
Yeah, definitely. I'd agree.
Halo 4, I did quite a few remakes of Halo 3 in that one. Somehow I was able to fit the entire map of Rat's Nest of a full-scale remake in Halo 4.
Nice. That's sick, man. what would you say, because of course in the co-op build you've been making a lot of remakes, what would you say the biggest challenge when you're making these remakes is? Would it be like trying to get the aesthetic close, or would it be trying to just like properly scale the remake for said game, whether that be Infinite with a co-op build or Halo 4.
My first remake I did on the leaked build here, Lockout, that one was, I did that one 100% by eye. But since then, we have figured out a few different tools to help us get scale proper going on a one-to-one scale. There's a few maps that I probably would test for Halo Infinite's matchmaking and get them more suitable for the new movement and whatnot. But my idea around recreating most of these maps is going to be custom games and bringing a classic Halo 3 style game type into Infinite's custom games, so we can get that Halo 3 feel on these maps.
Okay, so like cut out Sprint, cut out Clamber and all that, and have like the classic feel and stuff?
Yeah.
Nice.
Had a couple of the new Infinite Sandbox items in there to give it a little bit of a twist, but essentially, most of the maps will play pretty well with the Infinite's movement, but there are some you'll probably want to restrict the movement.
Definitely. Foge actually has a lot of experience with that from like Halo 5. He did. Foge, you want to put some words on that, I guess, since you did the Halo 3 throwback playlist?
Yeah, I guess. So basically, for the Halo 5 playlist, obviously they wanted completely scale remakes. They literally made a custom game type to match Halo 3's jump height and everything like that. So the scale had to be exactly the same. But clearly with Infinite, you want to make something that plays good, but also has the exact same kind of feel of the original map. So I would agree with UneeQ here and on like making those subtle little changes to make the map, you know, work slightly more.
100%.
The map that I've been working on lately has been High Ground, and with the whole snap slide and curb slide movement being in Halo Infinite, and this map basically having downhill, if you can capture that flag, yeah, I think it would completely break this map as a capture the flag map because of that movement.
Specifically like with snap slide or also with curb slide?
Probably both would definitely be an issue.
So how have you...
With a game type like Assault, just going up the hill, perfectly fine. But it's that one movement being able to slide down the hill faster.
Yeah, the one flag kind of... It's more drastic since you have to take the flag back to the beach.
Yes.
So how have you been combating that with the current High Ground remake that you're working on?
This one is probably going to be one of those map specific ones where it's no sprint, no slide, no clamber.
Okay.
That would be one that's pretty hard to adjust considering the map is all on a slant, essentially.
Definitely, yeah. I mean, I think that when it comes to like curb sliding and designing around that, it's going to be interesting to see how people ultimately combat that. I mean, from all the practicing that I've done, like when I was in the comp scene and stuff with it, it seems like it's only on like certain angles that it works. Like it will still speed you up if you're going downhill, but it's not like as much as like if you were going off a ledge onto another surface. But it'll be interesting to see how people ultimately combat that, because it is one of the new movement abilities, I guess is a way to put that. Like, granted, like a more casual player isn't probably gonna learn it as much, but like a more competitive player or even just like a moderately more competitive person will typically like either find it by accident or learn it, and that will change how a map plays for them compared to a casual player. So it'll be interesting to see how we ultimately design around that.
If you take that out of the equation, then like even the map would play fine with sprint, slide and clamber. It's just that one little trick, so it wouldn't be a good competitive map, but it would still be a fun social map for sure.
Definitely. When it comes to your past, you said like you started with 3 and Foundry and stuff, and you went up to Reach and 4 and built in those games. When it comes to like the difference between Halo 4, Reach 3, and of course Infinite, what would you say was the biggest challenge learning the new tool in the co-op flight compared to the MCC Forge or Halo 3 Classic or 4 Classic?
I found that it was... This is just me personally. I found that when I first loaded it up, it's like I have a little bit of experience with Unreal Engine and Unity and some 3D programs like Blender, and my brain clicked in and it thought I should be using a mouse and keyboard for this, and it just works perfectly. And compared to the other Forge modes, it's night and day.
My next question for you, actually, is what are some of the things that you use for inspiration when it comes to, like, new maps that you work on? Or if, like, you're making a remake and you want to make it, like, aesthetically different from the original map, what are some things that you take inspiration from, typically?
Believe it or not, I use AI generation for, like, concept art.
I forget what the bot's called, but so, like, where you just type it in and, like, just gives you, like, a unique art piece type of thing?
Yeah.
How often would you say you, like, use that? Is that, like, a thing you use, like, every single time, or would that be, like,
No, this is recent, brand new for me, but more or less that's where I've been gathering inspiration for maps that I will be working on. But in the past, what I've used for inspiration is more of old designer concept art.
So, like, from Halo specifically, or from, like, other games too, or?
Yeah, other games. I don't limit myself to make everything look like Halo.
What are some games that you've looked at the concept art for?
World of Warcraft is one of them.
Nice.
RuneScape is another one. I like the big expansive MMO and how they have different biomes and environments in them. So you get a lot of different concept art from those type of games.
That's sick. So more like fantasy style games typically, like when it comes to the variation of concept art, or?
Yeah.
Sick. I know that
my castles and medieval time type themes. So you'll probably see a few themes that are outside the realm of Halo, I guess you would call it.
That's awesome, man. Back in Halo 5, I actually tried to play around with, like, an Oblivion style aesthetic with the like inside the Oblivion Gate stuff. That'd be cool to kind of revisit. I'm kind of curious if, like, Oblivion and the Elder Scrolls games have their concept art public or not, because that'd be really cool to look back on some of that stuff, because I know that Bethesda typically has a lot of really cool and unique concept arts for their games, including, like, in, like, Fallout and stuff too. When it comes to creating these, like, aesthetic layouts and stuff, or not aesthetic layouts, these aesthetic designs from the concept arts, is it just, like, you try to, like, recreate it as close as you can, like, one-to-one, or do you, like, just get inspired off it and go, like, off on your own tangent of an art pass?
Well, it depends on what map I'm kind of recreating. The older games, there's not really much foliage or aesthetics to add to it, so the older games, it's kind of, you get a bit of a free range to add your own little touch to them.
Yeah.
But I try to get it as close as possible, but with adding a little bit more to it to make it more modern, so to speak, more updated to what the visuals could look like on a new engine. Like what I did with Guardian there, I added a lot more vegetation and foliage to the green section of the map. Go down there, you can actually see glowing fungus, and there's little lights that cast your shadows as you walk by them, and there's just so much you can work with within Halo Infinite's Forge. You can even have small effects of butterflies and bugs, and then audio emitters emitting sounds of owls hooting and birds. And it's just incredible, all the new things that you can add to these original maps that were never there to give them more immersive environment, that
more ambiance.
Previous maps. Yeah.
It's gonna be dope to see how everyone uses those, because, like you said, there's a lot more in Infinite's Forge that we're able to see just from the co-op flight that makes things just absolutely amazing, even with the maps that we have now. coming through there. Of course, like, there's been like other people posting their stuff too. Like, there was the Toy Story map, and someone made like a really detailed like destroyed city. And then you've been making all the remakes and stuff. Like, it's insane to see how much detail people are able to put into a lot of these projects overall. Even on just the co-op flight and what we have in that. When it comes to like making like the ambience and the sounds and all that type of stuff, like, is that something like you try to focus on the remakes at the moment? Like, try to make them like really, really detailed? Like, is that like something that you enjoy more than like the art or the level design? Like, what's your favorite part of the process, I guess the way to put that?
I enjoy it all, really, but my favorite part is seeing it all come together, finally take shape, and you finally get that block out done and you can walk around on it. And it's, to me, that's the best part. But something I definitely enjoy doing is arting the map, adding the foliage. It's very tedious, but to get that end result, it's definitely worth it.
Very satisfying.
And audio is always audio is always satisfying to place in there.
Would you say you spend the most time on the art or the audio typically when it comes to that? Because I know audio can be just as stressful sometimes to work with as the art sometimes. As like, sometimes you gotta get just the right sound or have the emitter be just far enough away so it's only in that one area type of thing.
The audio, you're more fiddling with the settings, and that can be tedious to some people, but there is a little less to do when it comes to audio. When it comes to arting and foliaging a map, there's usually a lot more placing of stuff, and you don't really have to scroll with any settings, so it's just you pick what you want and you place it down and place it again. Audio settings, you're scrolling through different settings, and then, as you said, you're fixing the emitter zones and how far you can hear it and whatnot. So it is a little bit more tedious, the audio, but there is a little bit less to do depending on your map, really.
Definitely. I guess it also depends on how much audio you want to have on the map in comparison to art, to where you have to actually kind of like make it go throughout the entire map.
Essentially, you can get a pretty good ambience with very few audio emitters placed down.
Definitely.
So I find myself taking more time to art the map than I do to add the ambience in. The overall picture of what I'm doing with Forge is to bring back everybody's favorite maps from MCC. I know it's 120 some plus maps and it's going to take a while, but we'll get there eventually. So make sure to follow me on the journey. It's going to be a long ride, but it's going to be a good one.
Hell yeah, brother. it's definitely going to be a long ride, and I wish you luck on Gemini whenever you get to that map. that'll be an interesting one to recreate. All right, everybody, thank you so much for coming out here to Creator Spotlight. Sorry if my voice was a little kind of bad again today. Got kind of sick again, which, you know, that's just my luck at this point. But thank you, everyone, so much again for coming out to Creator Spotlight, and thank you again for UneeQ for joining us on this episode. Hopefully you guys get to learn more about him and more about his process. Maybe learned a little thing or two here or there. But yeah, thank you, everybody, so much for watching, and remember, let's forge a new Halo.